The United States has the highest prison and jail population, 2,121,600 in adult facilities in 2016, and the highest incarceration rate in the world, 655 per 100,000 population in 2016. According to the World Prison Population List 11th edition, there were around 10.35 million people in penal institutions worldwide in 2015. The U.S. had 2,173,800 prisoners in adult facilities in 2015. That means the U.S. held 21.0% of the world's prisoners in 2015, even though the U.S. represented only around 4.4% of the world's population in 2015, comparing other English-speaking developed countries, whereas the incarceration rate of the U.S. is 655 per 100,000 population of all ages, the incarceration rate of Canada is 114 per 100,000 as of 2015. England and Wales is 146 per 100,000 as of 2016, and Australia is 160 per 100,000 as of 2016. Comparing other developed countries, the rate of Spain is 133 per 100,000 as of 2016, Greece is 89 per 100,000 as of 2016, Norway is 73 per 100,000 as of 2016, Netherlands is 69 per 100,000 as of 2014, and Japan is 48 per 100,000 as of 2014. Comparing other countries with similar percentages of immigrants, Germany has a rate of 78 per 100,000 as of 2017, Italy is 96 per 100,000 as of 2018, and Saudi Arabia is 197 per 100,000 as of 2017. Comparing other countries with a zero-tolerance policy for illegal drugs, the rate of Russia is 411 per 100,000 as of 2018, Kazakhstan is 194 per 100,000 as of 2018, Singapore is 201 per 100,000 as of 2017, and Sweden is 57 per 100,000 as of 2016. The incarceration rate of the People's Republic of China varies depending on sources and measures. According to the World Prison Brief, the rate for only sentenced prisoners is 118 per 100,000 as of 2015. The rate for prisoners, including estimations for the number of pre-trial detainees and those in administrative detention, is 164 per 100,000 as of 2015. In a 2010 interview, Harry Wu, a U.S.-based human rights activist and ex-Chinese labor camp prisoner, estimates that, "...in the last 60 years, more than 40 to 50 million people were in Chinese labor camps, but that period includes the mass incarcerations of the 1950s or the Cultural Revolution 1966-1976 and is not representative of modern China." U.S. incarceration rate peaked in 2008. Total U.S. incarceration, prisons and jails, peaked in 2008. On January 1, 2008, more than 1 in 100 adults in the United States were in prison or jail. Total correctional population, prison, jail, probation, parole, peaked in 2007. If all prisoners are counted, including juvenile, territorial, ICE, Indian Country, and military, then in 2008 the USA had around 24.7% of the world's 9.8 million prisoners. A 2008 New York Times article said that it is the length of sentences that truly distinguishes American prison policy. Indeed, the mere number of sentences imposed here would not place the United States at the top of the incarceration lists. If lists were compiled based on annual admissions to prison per capita, several European countries would outpace the United States. But American prison stays are much longer, so the total incarceration rate is higher. More comparisons. In the United States, women make up more than one-tenth of the whole prison population. In most countries, the proportion of female inmates to the larger population is closer to 1 in 20. Australia is the exception, where the rate of female imprisonment increased from 9.2% in 1991 to 15.3% in 1999. In addition, the United States has significant racial disparities in rates of incarceration. According to Michelle Alexander, the United States imprisons a larger percentage of its black population than South Africa did at the height of apartheid. The black imprisonment rate of South Africa could not have come close to today's American rate simply due to limited room. Notably, there's something of an international theme in countries comparing themselves to apartheid South Africa. There were instances where Australian journalists were drawing the same contrast relative to rates of imprisonment in their country. In the Huffington Post piece, "Mass Incarceration's Failure," attorney Antonio Moore states, "The incarceration rate for young black men ages 20 to 39, is nearly 10,000 per 100,000. To give context, during the racial discrimination of apartheid in South Africa, the prison rate for black male South Africans, rose to 851 per 100,000. A major contributor to the high incarceration rates is the length of the prison sentences in the United States. One of the criticisms of the United States system is that it has much longer sentences than any other part of the world. The typical mandatory sentence for a first-time drug offense in federal court is 5 or 10 years, compared to other developed countries around the world where a first-time offense would warrant at most 6 months in jail. Mandatory sentencing prohibits judges from using their discretion and forces them to place longer sentences on nonviolent offenses than they normally would do. Even though there are other countries that have a higher rate of committing inmates to prison annually, the fact that the United States keeps their prisoners longer causes the total incarceration rate to become higher. To give an example, the average burglary sentence in the United States is 16 months, compared to 5 months in Canada and 7 months in England. The U.S. incarceration rate peaked in 2008 when about 1 in 100 U.S. adults was behind bars. This incarceration rate exceeded the average incarceration levels in the Soviet Union during the existence of the infamous Gulag system, when the Soviet Union's population reached 168 million, and 1.2 to 1.5 million people were in the Gulag prison camps and colonies, i.e. about 0.8 imprisoned per 100 USSR residents, according to numbers from Ann Applebaum and Stephen Rosefield. Some of the latter Soviet Union's yearly incarceration rates from 1934 to 1953, however, likely were the world's historically highest for a modern age country. In the New Yorker article The Caging of America, 2012, Adam Gopnik writes, "Overall, there are now more people under correctional supervision in America—more than 6 million—than were in the Gulag under Stalin at its height." Topic. See also: List of U.S. states by incarceration rate, Incarceration in the United States, Youth incarceration in the United States, War on drugs.